Are you ready to give the Lord the best, regardless of what it might cost you? My dear brothers and sisters, today's gospel is taken from Luke chapter 17, verses 7 to 10. The parable hangs on two questions. One, would the master invite the slave to sit down and eat? And two, would the master thank the slave for his work? Ideally, we would say the answer to both questions is yes. The slave has worked hard all day and therefore deserves a break. And etiquette as well as good business practice demands that the master express appreciation for his labors. But Jesus expects his listeners to say no. I won't invite my servant or slave to eat with me after he has finished a day of work. Instead of inviting the servant to eat with him, the master will say, "Prepare my supper, get yourself ready, and wait on me while I eat and drink. After that, you may eat and drink yourself." It isn't just a one-sided relationship, however. In return for his or her obedience, the servant is given meaning, worth and security in life. The master has the duty of providing for his servant's necessities. So in return for loyalty, obedience and hard work, the servant is guaranteed security in life, security he otherwise would not have. The focus of the parable is on how to follow and serve Jesus, our master. Jesus asks a second question that expects a negative answer as well. Would he thank or reward the servant because he did what he was told to do? After all, the servant's work in the field and house, does the master owe him anything? Is there any credit due to the servant? Has he earned any merit? It is these questions which expect a negative answer. When a servant in those times does what he is commanded to do, the master does not owe the servant any special favor or merit. The servant is only doing his duty and cannot expect a reward. Here is Jesus' application. So you also, when you have done everything you were told to do, should say, "We are unworthy servants. We have only done our duty." By unworthy servants, scripture means servants to whom nothing is owed. Servants who do not expect and cannot expect a thanks. When we do what Jesus tells us to do, when we follow the Master, we cannot expect a reward. This means submission. This means obedience. This means dependence. Living in a culture with rights and entitlements, we too easily can expect God to seek our permission. But God owes us nothing. Instead, we owe Him everything. So the first thing we must do is acknowledge that Jesus is Lord and Master. Second, we must do our duty without complaint, without resentment, without reservation. We must do our duty. He doesn't ask our opinion about what we would like to do. He doesn't ask our opinion about when to move on or how long to stay. He is the Master. He tells us where to go, how long to stay, what to do, when to do, and how to do it. Disciples who see themselves as slaves do what their master commands. We are not to question the cost, the inconvenience, the risk. Rather, we are to hear the master and obey his will. Are you ready to give the Lord your best, regardless of what it might cost you? Perhaps we are like the laborer in Jesus' parable who expected special favor and reward for going the extra mile. Don't we love to assert our rights? "I will give you only what is required and no more." Lord Jesus, fill my heart with love, gratitude and generosity. Make me a faithful and zealous servant of you. May I generously pour out my life in loving service of you and for others, just as you have so generously poured yourself out in love for me. Amen.